How long do you usually travel from home to work or to the University of Birmingham? 15, 30 minutes, 1 hour, 2 hours or more? And how does that make you feel? Let me walk you through what used to be my commuting journey when I lived in Jakarta, Indonesia. It starts with a rushed walk to the train station on a narrow and uneven sidewalk, just like in the picture to your left. At the station, I have to anxiously wait for the train to arrive. And when it does, it's usually packed full of people and I have to squeeze myself in, just like in the middle picture. After 30 minutes of feeling tense, I get off the train and I walk to work. But this time, the sidewalk is wide and it's clean. I can see tall buildings around me, just like in the picture to your right. I feel more at ease, more relaxed. I finally arrive at my office and I'm ready to work. This journey shows how commuting is an emotional, psychological, and sensory experience that can affect both our short-term emotion and long-term well-being. My research aims to explore how commuting behaviors and experiences affect subjective well-being, particularly among public transport users in Greater Jakarta, Indonesia. So far, from literature review, I found that commuting affects subjective well-being through multiple pathways, including life satisfaction, social interaction, and health. However, these findings vary widely as commute-related well-being is highly context-dependent, shaped by environmental, cultural, and socioeconomic factors. I use a mixed methods approach, combining quantitative and qualitative analysis. From a survey, a statistical model will be developed to measure how commuting factors like duration and mode affect subjective well-being indicators, including short-term emotion, long-term life satisfaction, life goals, and self-acceptance. Then, commuters' interviews and travel journals will be qualitatively analyzed to provide deeper insights into how people navigate their commute, how they interact with others, and to capture their emotional and sensory experiences throughout their journey, and how these factors influence their overall well-being. The findings from my research will bridge the discussions between macro-level public transport issues like infrastructure and accessibility with micro-level emotional experience of commuters. It will also provide insights to the Indonesian policymakers and urban planners, especially into designing well-being-oriented, accessible and inclusive public transport spaces to enhance commuters' well-being. Thank you.